In this video, you'll learn if Mixpanel or Amplitude is the best product analytics tool out there, and perhaps more importantly, if it's the best choice for your organization. Now, I work with over 80 plus companies, helping them implement both of these tools, and of course, other tools like Segment.com, Google Tag Manager, Google Analytics, Braze, and so on. So I wanna give you the more nuanced take as to where each tool shines, where they are pretty much the same, and what should be the right fit for your organization. What are the things you should keep in mind? I wanna take you through about six criteria: technical reliability, ease of use, pricing, integrations, other features that might offer, and privacy. Some of those, what I think are perhaps the six major attributes that you should consider. And I'll mention a few other things along the way, some maybe more of the hidden things you might not learn until you're really, you know, 3, 6, and 9 months into trying to use a tool. So someone who works with these tools every day, who does a lot of work with them, there's some things I notice where I think, ah, okay, yeah, this works really well, this is a little annoying. So I'm gonna give you some of those hidden things. So let's jump right in with technical reliability. Now, with everything I do, I'm gonna share my screen. I think it's the best way to provide a visual explanation of what I do. So let's jump right in. So we see here the different SDKs, and this is the first thing we wanna look at in a technical reliability element. Do they have the right SDKs? You can see at a glance that they're pretty similar, right? You know, they both have JavaScript. Amplitude calls them a browser. They have iOS and Android, Java, and then it kind of gets kind of interesting, right? So Unity is both there, Unreal is not, Mixpanel has Ruby, but Amplitude doesn't. So depending on whatever your product is built on, you just want to double check that the SDKs are here, they are maintained, they are the latest version, they have all the functionality compared to the standard ones. I would consider the browser JavaScript SDK the most standard SDK. So if you want to compare the tracking methods or the available features in any SDK, just compare them to the JavaScript one. That will tell you what's supported and what's not. But if an SDK is not here, your implementation will be much harder. So if you, for example, if you have something to do with Unreal, the Amplitude will get more weight because it's there. You might be able to do a custom kind of integration without it in Mixpanel, but it'll just be much more work. So that's really the first thing. Now, working with both SDKs, I find them to be very, very similar. I have never found much issues working with the SDKs themselves in terms of things not being supported or the documentation being out of date. So that's, I think, a very solid point for either one. Once you have this SDK and you start to send data, it is something that can be worked out for the most part in most products. You know, whatever kinks come up, you can do that. So on the technical reliability, apart from the differences in potential SDKs, they're both very similar, very good at being able to ingest data and do it rapidly and do it in real time. Now, let's look at ease of use. So I'm gonna go here to my second tab. So here are two reports I've built that are some kind of similar in structure. I find them to be very similar when it comes to building reports. That is your sort of point and click through different elements in the interface. You can add events, you can filter things, you can break them down. You can see the language is a little bit differently. Mixpanel calls them breakdowns, Amplitude calls them group bys. The Amplitude language is actually much more closer to SQL than not, but that's just an aside. So I find that to be pretty, very comparable on the ease of use. Now where it gets different is I find Amplitude has a little bit more advanced reporting functionality. Some of the things it can do around formulas, around segments, around some other more, you know, things like the rolling averages, rolling windows. You cannot always do in Mixpanel just as easily, just as more detail. But Mixpanel also has some reporting tweaks that Amplitude doesn't have. So I would give the edge to Amplitude here because they have a little bit more in terms of how you report it. But again, they're both very comparable, and you wouldn't really see them unless you're going to kind of advanced analysis. Where they do differ when it comes to sort of ease of use isn't just the scale of reports. So you can see Mixpanel has the 4 reports. They have a few other ones that are not available here by machine learning, but Amplitude does have more reports overall. So if you look at, here, there's actually maybe about 5 or 6 reports that just do not exist in Mixpanel altogether. Again, they're the advanced reports, typically the ones that use machine learning. They don't really apply unless you have millions of data points and you're most likely on some kind of paid or enterprise plan. But if you think long-term, if you think multiple years, then this becomes a factor. So they do have a little bit more on the reporting side here. Otherwise, the core stuff that you would expect the export to CSV, build in reports, build in dashboards, share in those. I find it to be pretty good. You might give Mixpanel an edge. I do think their interface is a little prettier, and not just the colors, but I just think that it feels a little bit more modern than the Amplitude one. But again, that might just be a visual preference. So let's look at pricing. Now, this is actually where we get some major differences. These companies have been changing the pricing multiple times over the past few years. They're going back and forth between charging by events or charging by monthly track users. This is what is available on March 2024. The pricing, they both have a free plan, right? They give you the core report, typically the segmentation, the funnels, the retention. There's some dashboard functionality. So the pricing and the free plan is somewhat similar. I would say the Mixpanel is much more friendlier. You have 20 million events. Amplitude, I believe, gives you 100,000 monthly track users. This may not be an issue, but if you're a consumer app, this will be a limit that you might hit quite quickly, especially if you're driving any kind of growth through paid acquisition. And I have many organizations who hit the limit pretty quickly. I find that 20 million events gives you much more of a margin than the monthly track user focus. Amplitude also has some, what I think are kind of like weird limits. I believe the free plan only lets you create 10 charts, again, as of March 2024. And again, you'll quickly kind of hit 10 charts in any kind of product organization. So the Mixpanel gets an edge here on the free plan. I find their growth plan also a little bit easier to grow into. So when you look at the build your plan, you can choose your event count, and then you can then pay that on some kind of monthly annual basis. I think it's a little bit more of a gradual way to get to grow into it. Amplitude now has this middle plan, and you can see some of the levels here, again, from monthly track users, but they don't seem to be that much. Again, you know, you have 10,000 monthly track users, 25,000 monthly track users. Keep in mind the monthly track users will likely also include anonymous website visitors. It doesn't have to, you can ignore them, but typically most organizations have that. So this plan may not be as friendly, and you may be finding yourself paying $10,000, $20,000 a year very quickly. So on the pricing side, I would give the edge to Mixpanel. I think it's easier to grow into it. You get more value out of it before you get to the the higher annual pricing levels. If this is not a concern for you, then it doesn't matter. But that's just my thinking on this. Let's look at integrations now, the fourth item. Now, Amplitude has a very deep level of integration. So you have the typical stuff like data warehouses, Amazon Redshift, Snowflake, BigQuery, you have them here. This is an extra option, an add-on for Mixpanel as a note. But the ones we care about are the other ones, the non-data warehouses one. You can see that Amplitude has about 133 of those. There's maybe about 125 non-data warehouse options here. And there's a lot of stuff you can do, right? So all the email marketing tools like Marketo and Klaviyo and Salesforce, there's ad platform. Mixpanel has a lot of those as well, but the Amplitude ones are just much more extensive. So you can send, for example, raw events. So you can send your raw data to a destination. And in that way, Amplitude functions much more as a CDP, as a customer data platform, versus Mixpanel typically is not sending the raw data, it is sending cohorts. So you're sending a list of emails, and those emails then get applied in some way. The most common example is you create a cohort of all the users who onboarded, but did not finish the onboarding, and now you want to target them with specific emails. That's sort of what Mixpanel is sort of built for. Amplitude can do that as well, but by sending the raw data, you get much more functionality out of it. So this raw data, raw events functionality is much more comparable to like a segment.com as a heads up. So on the integration side, Amplitude definitely has a clear edge. There's many more options. It's much more extensive. It's much more built out. Now, quick break before we move on to the last couple items. If you're looking for help making this decision between Amplitude and Mixpanel, or of course implementing the decision you choose, check out my website. So you can go to rubengarza.com/analytics. You know, I work with over 80 plus organizations, and on average, I save them about 30, 40 hours and about $30,000 in time and investment that was not wasted by choosing the wrong tool or implemented incorrectly. So if that's something that you might be interested in, check out my website. And we might be a good fit for each other. Let's go back to the regular video. Now let's look at some other features before we move on. I would tell you that Amplitude again has an edge here. They have an experiment, so they have a way to run A/B tests here in the product. That's something that Mixpanel does not have. They used to have it for mobile back in the day, a long time ago. Now they don't. This actual experiment is not quite the same as Amplitude. Amplitude has built on a way to handle experiments. to do the experimentation logic. The Amplitude experiments is an add-on. Typically, I see it with enterprise organizations. And if you have something like WVO or Chameleon or something like that, then you might not need it. The CDP functionality I mentioned before in the integrations, I consider that just a completely different feature as well. Something that Mixpanel does not have. So again, depending on what you're looking for, some of those machine learning reports I mentioned earlier that just simply do not exist in Mixpanel may be relevant to you. So some of the things to consider when you're looking at a tool. So if you're looking for all those things, Amplitude has a clear winner altogether here. They do not exist in any comparable fashion in Mixpanel. And then lastly, let's look at some privacy. Different ways, they both have GDPR APIs, that is APIs that you can use to send deletion requests. So not a problem. And you can automate that process if needed. And they can both actually be quite privacy friendly. So in both cases, you don't have to send PII, right? For example, this email here, this name, you don't have to send that. Even the user ID that you sent to Mixpanel on Amplitude, you can hash it. I've done that in other projects. You don't have to send the IP address. So, you know, we have the city and region here. You can skip that all together. So whatever things you can do, they're both pretty comparable here. I would say they're quite equal in the privacy functionality, how you can make these tools privacy friendly and how you can deal with the many privacy laws that are appearing every day as we go on here. So in conclusion, I would tell you that, in my opinion, I think Amplitude is a better product analytics tool. It just has much more functionality, just at its core level, at its core report level. It's typically my go-to product analytics tool if I get a recommendation. But depending on some situations, some caveats, Mixpanel might win. Pricing is one of those, right? I do think Mixpanel has a better pricing. So for younger startups, it might be a better fit. I think visually it's nicer. you may not care about that, but I just think that that's the case. So that's another edge for Mixpanel. Amplitude again wins if you're thinking about any kind of integrations. Just the level of depth of integrations is very strong. If you already have something like a segment so on, then you don't care about that. Experiment, something Amplitude only has, right? Again, if you already have that, then you don't care. But that's where it stands. Amplitude is a great first choice. Mixpanel wins in some cases. However, I always tell clients the same thing. You know, if you don't care about any of those specific things and you're just looking at the core functionality, the core reports, the dashboards, then you really can't go wrong with either. So you can see there's a lot of similarity to it, but just a few nuanced points that you want to think about and tackle before you make the right choice. My name is Ruben Ugarte. I help organizations implement their data tools like Mixpanel, Amplitude, Segment.com, and so on. So again, if there's something that you want help with, check out my website, rubenugarte.com/analytics. And let's see if that's a good fit for what you're looking for. We're on YouTube, so make sure to like, subscribe, and comment anything else you want to do here on YouTube. And in the comment section below, let me know, which do you think is the best tool? Do you agree with my assessment? Do you think Mixpanel is a better tool? Do you think Amplitude is still the best tool? I would love to hear what you think. So put that in the comments below. And until next time, talk soon.